want to come to every Bible study on Tuesday. He said, because you want to preach the word of God. And you want to be a man of God. So stand as a man of God, but you need to learn the word of God. So he said, anytime they have Bible study or any place to learn the word, come. Because he's saying, you will be out there preaching one day. But you have to learn and humble yourself under a leader first. So come to every Tuesday night Bible study. Learn the word. He's saying, watch. After 3 months, you'll start to see what God is talking about. You'll start to move in places that you thought you'd never hear God say before. You start to talk to people in confidence. So God is giving confidence in your heart right now.
Thank you, Jesus.
That you won't stumble, you won't fret, you won't be afraid
to talk
to people about God. But the Spirit of God will ignite the fire inside you. Say, I learned this in Bible study. Let me impart this into somebody else. And as I'm imparting it to their life, I'm standing on that word I want to preach. So don't just preach it and don't live it, but live it and preach it.
Jesus.
And watch God turn around everything for you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
See, I remember God saying, you need to subtract person out of your life. I don't know who it is, but subtraction.
Jesus.
You're saying, I don't know, they ain't in my life, I don't know like yet, but they may come.
Thank you.
God said that you need to be single and in a lone place, spiritually, for a season. What does that mean? God is saying, I need to be able to talk to you where nobody else interfere, where you're not distracted. So he's saying you get a prayer closet, a prayer sanctuary, a prayer corner in your house.
Jesus.
Because it seems like people keep coming in and out your house any kind of way. They saying any kind of thing. They live in any kind of way and you're just allowing it to happen. But God said this season and this year, you have to cease it. By fasting, by worship, by coming to church, by really reading your word. Because I don't want to see you out here saying you're going to get a new job. You're going to be prosperous. Because God's saying your spirit needs to go to another place. Your spirit is lacking. Your spirit is grieved.
Thank you, Lord.
And God said, I can't speak to my spirit because my spirit is grieved. And you're saying, Lord, why can't I hear what you're saying? Why can't I say what you say like other people do? Because he's saying, you haven't fed my spirit. The spirit is like a muscle. The more you lift weights, the bigger it gets. The more you reach your word, the stronger the spirit gets. The more you fast, the more you pray, intensifies. The more you reach your word, the more your worship goes higher. And God is saying, if you work your spiritual muscles, when the enemy comes in your house next time, you'll say, not so, devil. Because the Lord told me, I am powerful. I am more than a conqueror. I am the head and not the tail. I am above and not beneath. So you won't come in my house any kind of way. You won't teach my child any kind of thing. But today, I stop the curse, and I stop the generation, and I stop everything that tries to stop your spirit from growing.
Thank you, Lord.
So God is saying, get your prayer coin.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Come against those things that are not of God.
Yes.
And watch how your spirit comes up.
Thank you, Jesus.
And then people that come around you say, let me not mess with her. Let me come in the right spirit, a humble spirit, and respect her as a woman. Respect her as a mother. Respect her as a woman of God that goes to church and believes every word that God stands on.
I'm
telling you, watch. for you and they act like you just sister so-and-so and you just, oh, that's just her. But God said, more inside.
Yeah.
asking, Lord Jesus, supply, Lord God.
Yes, God.